Yesterday was a big news day, and Ainslie was fortunate enough to actually be at the White House to talk to the president.
That's right. We went down there and sat outside of the Rose Garden and talked to him about the news of the day, Michael Cohen, Paul Manafort, Jeff Sessions. We talked about a lot of things, wide-ranging issues. Here is, and we're going to air the entire thing in its entirety, but here's the president talking about Cohen, Manafort, and Jeff Sessions. Mr. President, thank you so much for sitting down with me. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. We had an incredible rally last night in West Virginia. It was beautiful, a tremendous crowd, and I think we're going to win a race, a big race over there. And I guess you could say that our numbers in winning, whether it's for the Senate or for Congress or for governor, has been very good.
How is our country's first lady doing, and how are your children?
She's doing great. She's a terrific woman. She goes through a lot with all this publicity, but she's a terrific woman. She's doing great.
How do you handle all of that?
Well, it's a part of my life. I guess my whole life has been this way. Somebody said, oh, gee, this is always such yeah. controversy. And I don't know, I've always had controversy in my life, and I've always succeeded. I've always won. I've always won. It was controversial when I ran, and I won. And now the country is doing better than it's ever done. You know, we have the best economy we've ever had in the history of our country. And more jobs today, literally today, we have more jobs, more people working in the United States than ever before in the history of our country. Black unemployment, Asian unemployment, women unemployment, Hispanic unemployment, historic lows. It's been an amazing thing. And, you know, unfortunately, the media never covers that. They don't like to cover that kind of thing. They like to cover nonsense.
Right.
But it's one of those things.
Well, speaking of yesterday, huge news day. There's a lot breaking today as well. Michael Cohen, tell me about your relationship with him.
Well, he was a lawyer for me for one of many. You know, they always say the lawyer, and then they like to add the fixer. Well, I don't know if he's a fixer. I don't know where that term came from, but he's been a lawyer for me, didn't do big deals, did small deals, not somebody that was with me that much. You know, they make it sound like I didn't live without him. I understood Michael Cohen very well. Turned out he wasn't a very good lawyer, frankly, but he was somebody that was probably with me for about 10 years, and I would see him sometimes. But when I had deals and big deals, I had outside lawyers, and I have a lot of inside lawyers, too, in addition to Michael. I always found him to be a nice guy.
He said one story, said you didn't know anything about the payments.
No.
And now he's saying that you directed him to make these payments. Did you direct him to make
these
payments?
He made the deal. He made the deals. And, by the way, he pled to two counts that aren't a crime, which nobody understands. I watched a number of shows. Sometimes you get some pretty good information by watching shows. Those two counts aren't even a crime. They weren't campaign finance.
Did you know about the payments?
Later on, I knew. Later on. But you have to understand, Ainslie, what he did, and they weren't taken out of campaign finance. That's a big thing. That's a much bigger thing. Did they come out of the campaign? They didn't come out of the campaign. They came from me, and I tweeted about it. You know, I don't know if you know, but I tweeted about the payments, but they didn't come out of campaign. In fact, my first question when I heard about it was, did they come out of the campaign? Because that could be a little dicey. And they didn't come out of the campaign, and that's big. But they weren't, it's not even a campaign violation. If you look at President Obama, he had a massive campaign violation, but he had a different attorney general. And they viewed it a lot differently. You know, we have somebody that they seem to like to go after, a lot of Republicans. But he settled his very easily. In fact, I put that out fairly recently. So Obama had it. Other people have it. Almost everybody that runs for office has campaign violations. But what Michael Cohen pled to weren't even campaign related.
Why weren't crimes. Why is he doing this?
Because
he's your attorney.
Because he made a great deal. Because he was in another business, totally unrelated to me, where I guess there was fraud involved and loans and taxicabs and all sorts of things. Nothing to do with me, because he had an outside business. He worked for me. Mm-hmm. You could really say it was more or less part-time. He had other businesses. He had other clients. I'm not his only client. And Michael Cohen had, I guess, a taxi business, and somebody reported him for some things in his taxi business, and that's how this started. And they put the two counts of campaign violations in there, but a lot of lawyers on television, and also lawyers that I have, say that They're not even crimes.
If you're saying the payments, if they're not illegal, then why would he use that information for a
because
plea deal?
Because he makes a better deal when he uses me, like everybody else. And one of the reasons I respect Paul Manafort so much is he went through that trial. You know, they make up stories. People make up stories. This whole thing about flipping, they call it. I know all about flipping. For 30, 40 years, I've been watching flippers. Everything's wonderful, and then they get 10 years in jail, and they flip on whoever the next highest mm-hmm. one is, or as high as you can go. Mm-hmm. It almost ought to be outlawed. It's not fair, because if somebody's going to spend 5 years like Michael Cohen, or 10 years or 15 years in jail because of a taxi cab industry, because he defrauded some bank, the last two were the tiny ones. You know, campaign violations are considered not a big deal, mm-hmm. frankly. But if somebody defrauded a bank and he's going to get 10 years in jail or 20 years in jail, but if you can say something bad about Donald Trump and you'll go down to 2 years or 3 years, which is the deal he made, in all fairness to him, most people are going to do that. And I've seen it many times. I've had many friends involved in this stuff. It's called flipping, and it almost ought to be illegal. You get 10 years in jail, but if you say bad things about somebody, in other words, make up stories, if you don't know, make up stories, they just make up lies. Alan Dershowitz said, compose, right? They make up lies. I've seen it many times. They make up things, and now they go from 10 years to they're a national hero. They have a statue erected in their honor. It's not a fair thing, but that's why he did it. He made a very good deal. I mean, for what he did. But I'll tell you that somebody made a better deal. Awand, the IT guy for Schultz, Congresswoman Schultz. He had all the information on Democrats. He had all the information on everybody. He went to jail holding the hands of the Justice Department and the FBI. They sat there together. They were smiling and laughing. And he got nothing. Well, and he stole money. And he had more information on corruption of the Democrats than anybody. And they don't even have his computers and his servers. They just gave him nothing. You saw that. It was on your show. They gave him nothing. Nothing.
Double standard?
Double standard. I mean, he was worse than anybody, in my opinion. He got nothing. He's a Democrat. He got nothing. The reason he got nothing, because the Dems are very strong in the Justice Department. I put an attorney general that never took control of the Justice Department, Jeff Sessions. Never took control of the Justice Department. And it's a sort of an incredible thing. We have this country going so well. Mike Pompeo is doing incredibly. All of my people, they're doing incredibly. But the whole thing with going on with Justice and FBI, when you mm-hmm. see Strzok and his lover, Lisa Page, when you see Comey with all the lies that he's told, when you see Mueller with the conflicts, he's so conflicted. Comey's his best friend. He had a really nasty business transaction with me, which he never reported. I've been talking about he never reports it. I mean, you look at the bad things. He wanted the FBI job that Christopher Wray has. Now, Christopher Wray was recommended by Rosenstein. The FBI, I'll tell you what, if you took a poll in the FBI, I guarantee you one thing, I'd do very well.
Are you considering pardoning Paul Manafort?
I have great respect for what he's done in terms of what he's gone through. You know, he worked for Ronald Reagan for years. He worked for Bob Dole. He worked, I guess his firm worked for McCain. He worked for many, many people, many, many years. And I would say what he did, some of the charges mm-hmm. they threw against him, every consultant, every lobbyist in Washington probably does. If you look at Hillary Clinton's person, you take a look at the people that worked for Hillary Clinton. I mean, look at the crimes that Clinton did with the emails, and she deletes 33,000 emails after she gets a subpoena from Congress. And this Justice Department does nothing about it? And all of the other crimes that they've done, and they don't. Look at Podesta. Podesta was supposed to be Manafort on steroids. They made him close up his firm. He was going to be indicted the next day, we heard. Never happened. Instead, they would go after Manafort. So, look, I didn't know Manafort well. He wasn't with the campaign long. They got him on things totally unrelated to the campaign. And by the way, they got Cohen on totally unrelated to the campaign. I'm not involved. I wasn't charged with anything. You know, people don't like to say that, but I wasn't charged. Mm-hmm. But when you look at the corruption on the other side, and they refuse to look at anything. When you don't look at Strzok, where he said, basically, we're going to take out the president, the insurance policy and everything else. You look at Lisa Page, the two lovers back and forth with these horrible texts. You look at the kind of talk going on about, it's really subversion. And our Justice Department doesn't do anything about it. People would say, oh, but you appointed Jeff Sessions. I said, I did. But I really feel, as long as this is going out, I don't have to do this, but I will stay uninvolved, and maybe that's the best thing to do.
Mr. President, a lot of people are frustrated. A lot of your supporters are frustrated with the DOJ, with Jeff Sessions. There are rumors that you're going to fire him after the midterms and Rosenstein. They also want these documents. They're wondering if you will use your power to get these documents released.
At the right time, I think I'm going to have to do the documents. I didn't want to, but I think I'm going to have to. There's such corruption before I got here. It's from before I got here. It's the Obama administration. And you look at what happened. They surveilled my campaign. It's very simple. The Pfizer report, the phony fake.
Rosenstein signed the last Pfizer report.
It bothers me. It's always bothering
me. Will you fire him? Will you fire Sessions?
Well, I'll tell you what. As I've said, I wanted to stay uninvolved. But when everybody sees what's going on in the Justice Department, I always put justice now with quotes. It's a very, very sad day. Jeff Sessions recused himself, which he shouldn't have done, or he should have told me. Even my enemies say that Jeff Sessions should have told you that he was going to recuse himself, and then you wouldn't have put him in. He took the job, and then he said, I'm going to recuse myself. I said, what kind of a man is this? And by the way, he was on the campaign. You know, the only reason I gave him the job, because I felt loyalty. He was an original supporter. Mm-hmm. He was on the campaign. He knows there was no collusion. And what's come out of Manafort? No collusion. What's come out of Michael Cohen? No collusion. This is stuff that they got.
Right.
How about with Michael Cohen, in all fairness to him, they raid his office at 6 o'clock in the morning? And how about with Manafort? They raid his home at like 5 in the morning, I think on a weekend, and his wife is in bed, and they go in with guns?
Yeah.
This is an Al Capone.